So I've bought a cheap Chinese diesel heater. I'm going to use it to heat this workshop. It's 36 square meters, about 390 square feet. Exactly what this wasn't designed to heat. So with this heater, I've done a couple of mods to it already. I've rerouted the fuel lines. I didn't like where they were going. Got rid of a bunch of coils. It was a lot longer than I thought it needed to be. I've repositioned this control panel to make it easier for me to read. But this isn't its final position. I'm going to add a sand battery back here and twist that around. But tonight, what I want to do, it's night time, so it's only going to get colder. I want to do a 2-hour test, put a measured amount of diesel in. So that's our baseline. I'm going to put a litre in, possibly two, see how much fuel it uses over 2 hours, measure the inside temperature, the outside temperature as it is, and in say half hour increments, come back and measure it, see what it's actually getting to, what's outside's doing and what inside's doing. I've got a thermal camera so we can try and see what the heat's doing, how the thing's heating up, and overall just see how comfortable it is in there when we get to the 2 hour mark. And then tomorrow I'll do exactly the same thing again, but we'll run it on half speed, see if that makes a difference. So that's our start line there. Put the first litre in. What I did earlier is I measured a litre of water into this old bottle after I'd cleaned it. I figured it was the safest way of doing it without sacrificing her best Pyrex measuring jug and my marriage. Right, so that's the first litre. Mark that off. That's one. Then I'll do the same again. I've put a wedge under there because the bottom of this isn't flat and it rocks. So I don't want to measure it this side and then it rock over and alter the height. Actually, make it there. So that's 2 litres. We're ready to go. I'm going to switch the heater on, and then from when it fires up, as in starts the as soon as the injector starts working, I figure we're good to go. That's when we start our clock. So every 30 minutes for the next 2 hours, we'll do a temperature check. At the moment, and I'll show you this in a minute, at the moment we're at 0 hour. We'll switch this on. It's 1.9 degrees Celsius inside and 0.9 degrees Celsius outside. All right, that's just started running now. So we're going to set this to gear 10, they call it, position 10, and start the timer. See, that's only been on for a total of 5 minutes, so that's not been running beforehand. So see, this is cold. That vent's at 24 at highest point. The body's cold. You see the exhaust just starting to heat up now. And we're just ramping up now to full speed. See, that's the floor heating up. You can see the pipe. That's our first 30 minutes. And we're 4.1 inside, and it's flicking between 0.9 and 1 degree on the outside. There you go. Diesel wise, 4 mil. Yeah, 4, maybe coming up to 5. So this is the hour mark, and we're 4.7 degrees Celsius inside. It's actually warming up outside, bizarrely enough. And diesel wise, we are about 8 mil. This is an hour and a half, 4.9 Celsius inside, 1.3 outside, so we're actually warming the weld up. Diesel wise, it's about 14, 15 mil. So that's 2 hours, 5.1 degrees Celsius inside and 1.2 degrees Celsius outside. Fuel uses about 19 millimeters. So it looks to be over 3/4 of a litre. Right, so that's our 2 hours. Disappointing, really. from half hour we was up to 4.1, and then at a total of 2 hours, we're still only 5 degrees in here. Admittedly, this is a big building for that little heater. It's not insulated and it's got a metal roof and it's cold out. But tomorrow I'm gonna do exactly the same thing again, but we'll do it at half speed, see if there was any benefit at all between having that thing roaring away or just ticking there nicely. I'll see you tomorrow. So it's the following night. This morning I did a video on changing the fuel pipes. Didn't quite go as I'd hoped, but if you want to look at that one, check this video out. But the only difference now is it's slightly warmer out. It was meant to be colder tonight, but it's not. It's 5.9 degrees. So we're starting at a lot higher temperature, but we're going to do the same as we did last night, but run it on half power to see what that does. Curiously enough, when I tested this morning to make sure there was no leaks, the combustion temperature was actually higher than it was last night. We were getting well over 200 degrees. I don't know if that was just because the ambient temperature was warmer or not, I don't know. But anyway, let's get on with this. But this is the results from last night. So there's a 1980s spreadsheet for you. See, swipe effect. We'll start this up, we're good to go. So there's our start temperature. It's actually just clicked over to 6 degrees. And then we'll start the machine. And again, I'll start the timer as soon as the injector starts firing. So that's the timer started. And we'll see what our temperatures do. Set this to position 5, so that's half speed. So that's the first half hour. And we're at 7.9 inside, 5.3 outside. So we've gone up again like last night. But if we look at the fuel level, that's dropped about 3 mil. It was this time last night, even though we're on twice the power, we dropped 4 mil. So it's not used an awful lot less fuel. But the confusing thing is if we look at this, if we look at the combustion chamber temperature, last night it was around about 180 to 195, but this seems to be sticking around 216. And the pump is modulating. Last night it was a constant click, 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 you set your watch by it. But now it's actually just slowed down there. And then it'll run slow for a bit, and then it'll just pick up again. So I don't know if that's just because it's not at full bore, and full bore is just it'll keep its foot down regardless, or whether this has had anything to do with that. Is it being able to give the correct volume of fuel because we've got a slightly bigger bore pipe on there? But the other thing is, last night you could hold your hand in front of this pretty much all night if you wanted to, but now that's starting to get uncomfortably hot there, right there. So I'm going to I'll get the thermal camera out and try and do some readings, but the exhaust seems to be running cooler, but this air seems to be hotter. I don't know if that's just in my head. So that's the hour mark, 8.6 inside, 5.2 outside. So it's actually dropping. Last night, I don't know if you remember, the temperature actually went up. So that's last night. Computer graphics are great, I know. 8.5, so that's an increase of, 0.7 in the last half an hour. Whereas last night, we only managed 0.6. So that's weird. Fuel levels dropped by another 3 mil, so we're fairly consistent now. We've used 6 mil since we started. And the combustion chamber temperature is staying between, sort of, it drops down to say 210, goes up to 220, but the pump modulates. So it seems to be doing its thing. And if we look at the floor, it was at 28 degrees, which is warmer than it was last night, which is again odd, but let's give it another half an hour. So out, that's the 90 minute mark, 8.6 and 5.1 outside. We've used 10 mil of fuel and the combustion temperature, yes, just pretty much staying the same. The floor is 33 degrees, so that's getting a lot hotter than it was last night. So this is strange, this isn't really what I expected. Right, last half hour, we'll see where we get to. That's the 2 hour mark. 8.7 or 8.8, yeah, it's just hovering around there, 5.1 outside. And fuel wise, we've used 14 millimeters. And the temperature of the floor is the same, 34 degrees, so that's kind of leveled off. And again, that's fairly consistent. So that's the final results, in case you're interested. Fairly close, really. So what do we know? Not a lot, really. It's kind of confusing. In some respects, it used more fuel than I thought it was going to. Last night, we were using about 4 mil and every half an hour. And tonight, we have been using 3 mil, even 4 mil towards the end. So, yeah, that's a bit of a surprise. You think at half speed, it would use half the amount of fuel. But if anyone knows how to get this blue controller, I want to change it to Hertz, because it's constantly sort of modulating, trying to maintain that combustion temperature, I suppose. But I don't know if that's had an effect on the fuel economy. I'd sooner just a constant click. This workshop, we was fighting a losing battle, really, to begin with. It's 36 square metres, 390 square foot, something like that. It's made of concrete blocks. It's single glazed, tin roof. There's no insulation anywhere. To be honest, worst case scenario this is. But if you had a smaller garage, or a smaller shed, or even something that's got insulation in it, this might do a lot better. But we're not finished yet. We've got the sand battery to build, try and recover some of that exhaust heat, because there's a lot of heat that goes out through the wall. So that's the next thing I think we're going to do. The barrel's on order. Then we've got to look at looping the exhaust. But hopefully you like this one. Thanks for watching to the end. If you could do me a favour and subscribe, helps me grow the channel. Watch this video here. Long list of demands. I'll see you on the next one.